Anxiety is a condition that is associated with a feeling of intense fear and tension. Anxiety disorders can be classified into different categories based on the symptoms and their root cause. One of the common anxiety disorder is the generalized anxiety disorder, where people may have anxiety for a few months without any proper reason. In a few people, anxiety may be associated with panic symptoms, and that type of anxiety disorder is called panic disorder. It is associated with physical symptoms like sweating, tremors, and rapid heartbeats. Another type of anxiety disorder is the social anxiety disorder, where people may have anxiety for social interactions, or they may have phobias towards a particular place, thing, or action. Obsessive-compulsive disorder is another type of anxiety disorder where the people may have anxiety due to fear of germs, and they may have repeated hand washing, or they may have fear of losing things, leading to development of anxiety. Another anxiety disorder is the post-traumatic stress disorder, where the people may have anxiety by recalling of stressful events that occurred in their life. So these are the five types of anxiety disorders with little difference in their root cause. Based on this, we have different types of anxiety medications that reduce the symptoms of fear and tension in the people. Anxiety medications can work in different ways. Few of the medications are going to act on the brain and they reduce the excitation. This results in the reduced stimulation of anxiety symptoms in the people. Few other medications relieve panic symptoms like rapid heartbeats and sweating. So in this video, we are going to discuss the top anxiety medications, and we will also discuss what are their advantages and disadvantages. The first one is the benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines are the well-known drugs which are commonly known as benzos, and they can be identified by their suffix "-pom". We have drugs like diazepam, clonazepam, lorazepam, temazepam, and so many other drugs. Another drug is the alprazolam, which is having the different suffix azolam, but still it is a benzodiazepine. And here drugs like clonazepam, alprazolam, and lorazepam are widely used to control anxiety. Benzodiazepines are having many advantages in controlling anxiety. They are sedative in nature, therefore they can reduce the aggressiveness in the people that may be associated with anxiety symptoms. That's why they are also called as minor tranquilizers. Another advantage is that benzodiazepines can also induce the sleep. Normally, anxiety is associated with lack of sleep. So in such people, benzodiazepines can induce the sleep, thereby they can improve the symptoms of anxiety. Third advantage of benzodiazepines is that they show immediate actions. So whenever you require to reduce the anxiety symptoms, benzodiazepines can work rapidly, and within the day, they can reduce the anxiety symptoms. Benzodiazepines work on the brain to increase the inhibitory response. Brain is a complex nervous system where many types of chemical mediators are involved. Among them, one of the inhibitory amino acid is the GABA, gamma-aminobutyric acid. Benzodiazepines increase the action of GABA, thereby they can increase the CNS inhibition. One of the targets of benzodiazepines is the GABA-A receptors. These GABA-A receptors are ionotropic receptors. That means they are made up of ion channels, and when they are activated, they can open the chloride channels, which enters into the cell, leading to hyperpolarization. However, to open these ion channels, GABA is required. Now, benzodiazepines are increasing the action of GABA. They are binding to an allosteric site on the GABA-A receptors. This is the site other than the GABA binding site. Now, when these benzodiazepines bind to this site, GABA can act on the GABA-A receptors, which promotes opening of chloride channels, leading to hyperpolarization. This results in the inhibition of neurons in the brain. In this way, benzodiazepines can control the anxiety symptoms by producing CNS inhibition. However, benzodiazepines are having few of the limitations in their uses. The first limitation is the sedation. Even though it is an advantage in terms of reducing anxiety symptoms, but whenever the sedation is excessively produced, it may impair attention in the people. This is particularly more important in the elders, where lack of attention may impair their daytime activities. And interestingly, The sedation produced by benzodiazepines can be further enhanced by other medications. For example, opioids are the centrally acting analgesics, which can again produce sedation and CNS depression. So these opioids should not be combined with benzodiazepines because this combination can produce severe sedation, respiratory depression and coma in the people. Similarly, alcohol can also have additive effect. While taking benzodiazepines, consumption of alcohol may increase the sedative effect, thereby it can severely impair attention in the people. That's why whenever benzodiazepines are used, caution should be taken while driving vehicles or working with machinery. Second limitation is the muscle relaxation. Benzodiazepines can produce motor incoordination. With long-term use of benzodiazepines, people may have slow movements as well as they can observe resistance to the movements. Again, this motor impairment is more troublesome in the elders. Third limitation is the cognitive impairment. Benzodiazepines can produce loss of memory. Even though it is a temporary loss of memory, they can impair the daytime activities. This condition is called retrograde amnesia, where benzodiazepines produce loss of memory of current events. Again, this side effect is troublesome in elders. So these are the three disadvantages of benzodiazepines. They may produce sedation, motor impairment, and cognitive impairment. Apart from these limitations, the overdose of benzodiazepines is also important, even though they are safe at normal doses. But at overdose, they can produce few of the symptoms like profound sedation, confusion, motor impairment, loss of balance, and double vision. That's why benzodiazepine should not be taken at overdose. And any accidental consumption of benzodiazepines can be treated by a few of the antidotes like flumazenil. Another important aspect is that benzodiazepine should not be stopped suddenly. Even though they are having less addiction, but on sudden stopping of their use, benzodiazepines can produce few withdrawal effects. These withdrawal effects are just like symptoms of anxiety. So people may have increased anxiety, nervousness, restlessness, and insomnia, lack of sleep, and even they may have increased risk of convulsions. That's why benzodiazepines should not be stopped suddenly, particularly when they are used for several months. Next, anxiety medication are the antidepressants. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are one category of antidepressants which can be used to treat the anxiety. They are commonly known as SSRIs, and they include few drugs like fluoxetine, citalopram, which is having its S isomer, escitalopram. Similarly, few other drugs like paroxetine, sertraline, all these are selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. These medications are actually intended to treat depression. However, they can also reduce the symptoms of anxiety, and they are useful in the people who are having both depression as well as anxiety. These drugs are going to increase the levels of serotonin in the brain by reducing their uptake into the neurons. Nowadays, SSRIs are the first-line drugs for treating anxiety because of their better efficacy on controlling anxiety symptoms. Similarly, selective norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors are another type of antidepressants which are again used to treat anxiety. They are commonly known as SNRIs. Drugs like venlafaxine and its dextroisomer desvenlafaxine, duloxetine are the popularly used drugs for treating anxiety. These medications can elevate the levels of two types of chemical mediators, serotonin as well as norepinephrine. If we see the advantages of these SSRIs and SNRIs, they are having the lower side effects compared with benzodiazepines, and they are less sedative in nature. They also lack of addiction that may be observed with long-acting benzodiazepines. Finally, another advantage is that these SSRIs and SNRIs can relieve both anxiety as well as depressive symptoms. However, again, these medications are having few of the limitations. The first and important limitation is that these SSRIs and SNRIs cannot be used for producing immediate actions. They need at least 2 to 4 weeks to relieve the symptoms of anxiety because they produce a physiological modification in the brain that relieves the symptoms of anxiety. Therefore, if you want to relieve the symptoms of anxiety immediately, SSRIs and SNRIs are not useful. However, they can be used to control the anxiety after a few weeks of the treatment, where they can show better efficacy and less side effects compared with benzodiazepines. And the limitation is that these medications can produce some sexual dysfunction. They can produce loss of libido, decreased sexual desire, and they may also produce difficulty ejaculation. Mirtazapine is another antidepressant which is classified as atypical antidepressant. That means it is a new generation antidepressant which acts by multiple mechanisms. The main action of mirtazapine is to increase the levels of serotonin as well as norepinephrine. However, it acts by different mechanism. It blocks alpha-2 adrenergic receptors which increase the release of these two mediators. This drug is also having few advantages. It is not producing motor impairment and memory impairment that were observed with benzodiazepines. And it is also not having sexual dysfunction that is observed with SSRIs and SNRIs. However, this medication can increase the appetite. Therefore, it may result in the weight gain in the people. So, mirtazapine is another option for treating anxiety where it can have less side effects with better efficacy. Next one is the buspirone. Buspirone is another popular drug to treat chronic anxiety symptoms. It is classified as 5-HT1A agonist. That means this drug acts as an agonist at 5-HT1A receptors. This initially results in the decreased release of 5-HT, but later, because of desensitization, 5-HT is more released due to the long-term use of buspirone. That's why buspirone takes at least 2 to 4 weeks to relieve the symptoms of anxiety. Again, this medication is not having the troublesome side effects that are observed with benzodiazepines or SSRIs and SNRIs. However, it can produce dizziness and restlessness as two important side effects. Next one is antipsychotics. Antipsychotics are particularly used to control the psychotic symptoms like hallucinations and delusions. However, these medications can reduce the aggressiveness in the people. That's why they are called as major tranquilizers. Few of the antipsychotics, particularly new generation antipsychotics, can relieve the symptoms of anxiety. For example, aripiprazole, quetiapine, and risperidone are the three important medications which are used to control anxiety symptoms. Particularly in the people where anxiety is associated with aggressiveness and agitation, these antipsychotics are highly useful. These medications are having mild side effects and well tolerated. These medications can produce sedation and weight gain as important side effects. Beta blockers. In few of the people, anxiety is associated with physical symptoms like palpitations, rapid heartbeats, sweating, and tremors. All these symptoms are due to the excessive stimulation of sympathetic system. Therefore, to control these panic symptoms, beta blockers like propranolol can be used. Propranolol is a non-selective beta blocker which can act on heart to reduce contractions. It can also act centrally to reduce sympathetic discharge. Therefore, it can control the panic symptoms and it is highly useful in panic anxiety disorder. Being a beta blocker, this medication can reduce the blood pressure. Therefore, it can produce hypotension as an important side effect. And it can also reduce the heart rate leading to bradycardia. Antiepileptics. Few of the antiepileptics like pregabalin, gabapentin, lamotrigine, and valproic acid can also reduce the anxiety. Particularly, these medications are used where anxiety is associated with excessive activation of neurons and increased neuronal excitation. These medications can reduce the neuronal excitation by blocking either sodium channels, calcium channels, or increasing the action of GABA. By all these actions, they can reduce the neuronal activation, thereby they control anxiety symptoms. Other medications. Antihistamines can also be used to control the anxiety, and among them, hydroxyzine is one of the widely used medication. Actually, this medication is used to control the allergic reactions like itching and redness of the skin. It can also induce the sleep, thereby it can relieve the symptoms of allergy. However, this medication can also reduce the symptoms of anxiety by induction of sleep. Similarly, alpha-2 blockers like clonidine can also be used to control the anxiety symptoms, where it can reduce the sympathetic activation and controls panic symptoms in the people. So these are the various types of anxiety medications that are used to relieve the symptoms of anxiety. Benzodiazepines are the popular drugs, commonly known as benzos. They are widely used to control the anxiety symptoms and they are highly useful for acute conditions. But they can have troublesome side effects like motor impairment, loss of memory, and profound sedation. Therefore, benzodiazepines are better used for short term to control anxiety. Antidepressants like SSRIs and SNRIs are the best choice of drugs for treating anxiety. But these medications require a few weeks to show their action, and they may produce sexual dysfunction as one of the important side effects. Mirtazapine is an atypical antidepressant which lacks sexual dysfunction, but it can produce weight gain as important side effect. Few of the antipsychotics can also be used to control the anxiety, and they can reduce the aggressiveness in the people. Antiepileptics like pregabalin, gabapentin, lamotrigine, and valproate are also used to control neuronal excitation, thereby they relieve the symptoms of anxiety. In the people with panic symptoms, beta blockers like propranolol can be used, which can reduce the rapid heartbeats, sweating, and tremor in the people. Hydroxyzine is an antihistamine, which can induce the sleep and reduce the anxiety. Alpha-2 blockers like clonidine can reduce the sympathetic discharge, thereby it also relieves the symptoms of anxiety. So these are the various types of anxiety medications that can be used according to the root cause of the anxiety, based on the troublesome side effects, patient's conditions, other co-prescribing medications. So that's all about the top anti-anxiety medications. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel and share this video with your friends and hit the like button to support our work. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.